YouTube family, you welcome back again to my channel. My name is Navina. For those who are joining for the first time, thank you so much for tuning in. In today's recipe, guys, I would like to share with you all how I make my Nigerian fluffy akara, aka the beans cake. This is very simple recipe. You don't need a mixer, you don't need a whisker, so sit back as I will be sharing with you shortly. Alright friends, you're welcome back again. So guys, here are the items I will need to make my Nigerian fluffy akara for today. Here I have my washed peeled beans, I have 2 small scotch bonnet pepper, 1 onion, salt to taste, and some seasoning powder. Okay, so if you want to know how I washed my beans, so feel free to check out on my previous video how I did it in less than 2 minutes. So next step for me is to add water to my beans and let this soak for about 20 minutes, okay, just to soften the beans. So after 20 minutes, I'm just going to just sieve out the beans through my strainer here just to remove the water because the beans is already soaked, and then proceed to the next step, which is to blend it. Alright guys, so it's time for me to blend all the items together. My washed chopped onions, my scotch bonnet pepper, as well as my beans. So if your beans are mulched, make sure to section it into 2 parts to enable quicker and faster blending. So at this point, I'm just going to just add in a little bit of water. So make sure you're not adding too much because we are going to make akara and not moi moi, okay? And as such, the beans content don't need to be watery. It needs to be a little bit thick and not too thick as well because your akara is going to be strong, okay? Yes, just keep on blending until everything is smooth. So here is my beans after blending it for a few minutes. Okay guys, you can see how smooth it is. So if you want to use a blender for this exact recipe, make sure to get a good quality blender because not all blender is capable of blending beans until smooth. So yes, I'm just going to just open my blender, yes, and then add in my ingredient, which is my salt and my seasoning powder. So for this recipe, I don't have any measurement for my beans exactly because it was just a quick one. So if you want to make akara without the measurement on your beans, so make sure to start by adding a little bit of salt to it and the seasoning powder as well. Don't forget the seasoning powder also contains salt on it. So when you're adding both of these items, make sure not to add too much, okay? Yes, and after adding everything into my blender, I just get a spoon, then stir everything to mix up, yes, and then go ahead to just blend it one more time for everything to properly combine together. Alright friends, so this recipe is the most simplest way to make Nigerian fluffy akara, okay? So we don't want to go back to the old ways where we use mortar and a pestle just to whisk our blended beans to get it fluffy, yes? So yes, that is it. This is very simple. This is beginners friendly. So even if you're new to making akara, you don't need to be scared. This is the perfect way. So yes, after blending everything, I just test my beans to see if the salt is enough. So if the salt is not, I will just add a little bit to it. So this is another part which is very, very important. So make sure not to deflate the bubbles inside your blended beans, because those bubbles inside are the ones that is going to make your akara fluffy, yes? So at this point, you don't want to stir anything, just leave it the way it is inside your bowl. Alright friends, so it's time for me to fry my akara. So I just added enough vegetable oil, which is going to be enough to fry my akara, into a deep pot. So you can also use a deep fry pan if you have one. And also I will need a spoon just like this to scoop in my blended beans into the hot oil. And I'm using enough oil because I don't want the akara sticking to the bottom of the pot, yes. So talking about oil, make sure the oil is not too hot, neither is it too cold, because if the oil is too hot, the akara is going to get burned and not cooking properly inside, okay? And also if the oil is also too cold, I mean if it's not warm enough, the akara is going to soak up a lot of oil and that won't be good, okay? So yes, after flipping my first session into the other side, so I'm using my skewer stick again to flipping the other akara to the other side for it to cook properly. And in total, I cook both sides for about 8 minutes, which means I cook one side for 4 minutes and the other side for 4 minutes. So try to flip over at intervally. That way you can control the brownness of your akara. That way one side doesn't get cooked than the other side. So just continue like this until everything is done. So yes, after a few minutes, here is my akara. Okay, everything is perfect, everything is fine. The akara was properly cooked, the color was not too brown, neither is it too dark. So everything was just perfect. So I just cooked the akara into a kitchen paper just like this. The kitchen paper is just going to help to absorb the excess oil I used in frying the akara. So yes guys, so after frying and after scooping, just use the spoon again to just, yeah, to remove all the excess particle of the akara from the oil before proceeding to the next frying. So love, what do you think about this my Nigerian akara recipe? Have you ever tried it before just like this without having to whisk it or using your mixer to whisk just to increase the bubbles or to inflate the bubbles inside? Yes, and if not, please, after giving my recipe a try back in your home, please do come back to leave a comment behind. I love to see those comments, I love to see those like, and please give me a like button. Even if you do not comment on my video, just give me a like to my video, okay? It means a lot to me, guys. Please, I need those like, because whenever I see those like, I intend to make more new videos for you all to see, guys. So yeah, so this is the next step, and this is also very important. Make sure you don't stir your beans content, the one in your bowl, okay? Because if you stir, everything is going to deflate, the bubble is going to escape, okay? And if you scoop the beans into your oil at this time, the akara is not going to rise. Yes, it's not going to rise, everything is just going to be flat in your oil. So make sure to avoid that. So here is my akara after frying everything. Everything was perfect. It is very, very beautiful. It is nice. So yes guys, don't forget to give me a thumbs up like I said before. Leave a comment behind, and if you have any question, please leave it in the comment section. Subscribe to my channel, turn on the bell to get the notification on my next update. Thanks for watching and see you on the next one. Stay blessed. Bye.